proud to call this neighborhood the headquarters of my campaign, and I really appreciate you putting this on tonight. I really am the guy that came to Baltimore 33 years ago in that pickup truck, and this city has given me everything that I have. I believe in Baltimore. Yet, this is the most important election in a generation. It will determine how we view each other, how we view this city, and yes, how the world views us. I have a plan for this city, David Warnock for mayor.com. But if you remember three things about me tonight, remember this. First, I'm about jobs and opportunity. For 15 years, I've been the chairman of the Center for Urban Families up on Monroe Street. I was the co-founder of Green Street Academy, which is now the most chosen middle school in the city. Second, I'm about real change and transparency, because we are way overdue for real change. And three, I deliver on my promises. Now that's the kind of leadership that we need in City Hall. Running for mayor is the culmination in many ways of my life's work. For 33 years, I've been connecting people, rolling up my sleeves, starting businesses, moving this city forward. The organizations that I've been involved with have either employed or helped to employ literally thousands of people. So if you remember three things about me tonight, I'll reiterate. I'm about jobs, and I'm about opportunity. I'm about real change and transparency. And I deliver on my promises. And I believe in my heart that we together will write the greatest turnaround story in America. Right here in Baltimore now. Thank you.
Listen to the candidates this evening. Candidates all want change. Candidates all have great ideas. Candidates all have plans of how they're going to implement. We have only one mayor who can be elected. We have a bunch of candidates who have many ideas. If you are elected mayor, would you hire any of those individuals who have presented ideas of how we can move the city forward?
Well, I'll tell you what's that. I'll tell you this. I told D-Ray tonight when we were talking up here that I expected to steal his best ideas. And I expected that he would steal my best ideas, and I've said that to other candidates who are up here tonight. You know, this is an election about creating accountability in the leadership in City Hall. This is an election that is about creating a culture of customer service that simply doesn't exist in City Hall. This is an election about respect. About respect for each other, about respect for a city government that time and time again is inadequate in the respect department. And it's about building a culture of promote from within. We need to build a city government where people are proud to work. People are proud to build a career. We can do that in our city.
But would you hire?
Would you?
Someone else have another question.
Would you?
We have a question right here.
But answer that one. Would you hire them or just steal their ideas?
You know what? In my administration, we will bring the best and the brightest. Everywhere I go in this city, I'm on a 276 neighborhood, 43 days in the university. The talent that resides in our city is extraordinary. The talent that resides up here is extraordinary, as is the talent in this room. As mayor of this city, it will be my responsibility to draw the best and the brightest in city government. And clearly, there's best and the brightest in the city come here to run. Yes, sir.
This is the issue I have. We hear a lot of rhetoric. A lot, that's kind of what we got, a lot of ideology. But one of yours is just pragmatic, because you haven't said anything really.
My dad told me once that character is what you do when the cameras are running. And not only will I tell you what I will do, I will tell you what I have done. I created a community school that's got 650 kids in it. I created a community school where our kids will get certifications in healthcare and energy and technology, where we have mental health professionals on site. And we are paired up with a great faith-based institution. We will spread that throughout the city. I created a company called Green Job Works. It's 40% owned by the Center for Urban Families and 60% owned by the management that has 125 people doing demolition and remediation right now. They did the demolition and remediation when we restored the old 91. We will expand that program throughout the city because I see our housing problem as an opportunity to put people to work.
Anyone have any questions? I'm from Mount Vernon. I lived all over this town. I'm a product of public school. I live here. I've got four friends on that panel. I don't want to ambush you or anyone else. But here's my question. If you look at this room, we're rainbow, and no one has talked about how we can get together. It's all about education. It starts with the parents. It starts with the leaders. But no one has talked about how this man and I can get together and talk about how to put things together to raise our city. No one has said that.
And that's why I was saying that open door policy is the best way to go.
So the question is, how do you do this, sir? How do you make this gentleman and I get together? How do you get us together so we can raise our children? We may have things in common. We may not know it. He may live on another side of town, but we have, all of us, have preconceived notions. He may not like me because of my hat.
Good one.
Okay? I may not like him, but I like his shoes. On the other hand, how does this gentleman and I get together to make sure that the kids we're raising can someday be in a place where we all are happy? How's that happen?
We have to have dialogue with each other and understand each other. We have differences and respect that based on culture, maybe religion or anything like that. Some people don't like me because of my hair.
You know, I kind of baited you because the answer is education.
I already said that.
I educate him on what I like. He educates me on what he likes. This gentleman may educate me.
And you have to come to a common
agreement. I know that.
Let him come to a common agreement.
I think we have another question out there.
We heard a lot about jobs. Everybody want to have jobs. But one problem with jobs is we have a lot of people in the city who are not qualified for those jobs.
Yep.
So when you bring a job to the city, how do you make that connection for those who are not qualified?
All right, we will have job training, and if you go to my website and you look up what I've said in the last time, the first thing that I talk about was that when I look on the application, there's a section on there asking if you're a felon or have you ever committed a crime before. And I talk about that in the last election and said I think that statement should be getting rid of. And so the councilman up here jumped on it and got rid of it, which was a great idea. But what I'm trying to say to you, in school where I'm from, every student are exposed to hands-on job training, plus education, math, English, everything. So I think that they should introduce that into the schools here so that they, although you're a good chemistry person, you still can do a hands-on job too, so that it will prepare you for a situation that whenever it comes up. So it should be introduced into the school, and that's where you should start from.
To follow up on the previous man's question regarding jobs, regarding the training, what industries, what sectors of Baltimore's economy do you feel you could grow, you could develop, for which such job training and education could be made relevant?
That's a good question. The infrastructure in the city is very, very, very poor at this time. So we know that all those infrastructures are going to need skilled people to take care of it. So what you have to do, you have to make a projection to fix this infrastructure, but you have to prepare the people to do it. So instead of have outside entities come in to do it, you know that within 2 years you're going to be taking care of this sector of the infrastructure. You train people for it specifically, and you take it to the community. What I have learned in this city, a lot of people would like to get work, but they're afraid to come out of their community. You have to go into their community. Not like this community is a very nice community and people interact with each other, but most of the community that I go to, people don't interact with each other because of whatever personal reason they are. So you would have to bring that job training to that community and say, look, this is what we're gonna do, and if you wanna be a part of it, you gotta be trained this way. Everybody, and thank you so much for waiting all this time for me and for all of these candidates to be able to talk.
My name is Calvin Young. I'm a candidate for mayor of Baltimore. And I'm running for mayor because we are in a state of emergency. Our city has faced 344 homicides last year, a $75 million budget deficit, and a quarter of our citizens live in poverty. That includes 42% of African-American children. When I talk to people on the streets of Baltimore, they agree, as I do, that we are in need of new, fresh leadership for the future of our city. I'm born and raised here in Baltimore. I grew up in Hamilton, in Northeast Baltimore, to a single mother who has worked since 1992 as a correctional officer in city jails. I went to Poly, studied mechanical engineering at New York University before working on Black Hawk helicopters and jet engines. I've managed large amounts of people and multi-million-dollar portfolios. I'm a former national chairman of the National Society of Black Engineers, so I've helped thousands of young people become excited and exposed to engineering and to become engineers themselves. I'm a graduate of the Harvard Business School, and I've worked at the White House at the National Economic Council, where I focused on manufacturing and small business policy. Now, you've heard from a lot of different people, and the difference between me and them is that they look at the past and ask why. I think about visions of the future and ask why not. I think about small business growth, the fact that Baltimore doesn't have a lot of small businesses, entrepreneurial activities, and the fact that access to capital is so tough, especially for people in African-American communities. You know, two-thirds of our city are African-American, but only one-third of businesses are owned by African-Americans. There's nothing against anybody else, but I see an opportunity for us to create jobs right there. We need a world-class subway system. And imagine all the felons that we have in our city, imagine if we can hire them, give them job training, to make subways, that's 20 years of jobs right here to help change the way that things are happening in our city. And I want to see universal pre-kindergarten for our children. I want to see algebra by 7th grade, calculus by 11th grade. Because if you hit those three, you can literally be anything you want in the world. So again, my name is Calvin Young. To learn more about me at electcalvinyoung.com. And I'm really happy to hear all the questions you may have. Thank you.
There are other people who are running for mayor.
taxpayer who would be better qualified to ask why there's an inequality between the taxes that big businesses and places like John Hopkins pay and what we pay as ordinary citizens. So I appreciate your question, but you know, you got to ask them. And if your decision of who you're going to vote for mayor is based on that, then I would tell you not to vote for the people who made those decisions. What I can also tell you is that, you know, we give incentives to a lot of, you know, large developers and big business owners in the city. Let's start doing things like that for small business owners. Two-thirds of all new net jobs in this country come from small business. Over 50% of people who are hired in this country are hired in small businesses. That's even more outside of Baltimore, because we don't have a lot of big businesses that hire a lot of people. So imagine if we're making these investments that we're giving to big businesses instead into small businesses, into our neighborhoods. Imagine what could happen in this city in the 21st century. So for a 21st century city, you need a 21st century mayor. My name is Calvin Young, and that's why I'm running.
Talking about public infrastructure. I'm an architect, so I understand that, and I've been working on infrastructure and built environment here for 11 years since I moved here. One of the big issues with that is that you know, you may be mayor for 4 years, you may be mayor for 8 years. It may take 30 years, 40 years to implement a metro system, a real subway network here, or any of those other things. So two questions. One, how will you overcome the friction, the administrative friction and the political friction of actually getting those huge things done, number one? And number two, how do you make sure it keeps going after you're out of office or even dead?
Good question.
So, you know, I think what the largest thing that you're talking about is there a mayor? Can I be a mayor that you can trust to get things done? To collaborate with both the municipality, the city council, with the state legislature, and with the federal officials to be able to make things happen. Because you're right, the city doesn't have enough money to make some of these ideas like a world-class subway system to happen by itself. And absolutely, I can do that. Again, I've been a manager of lots of people as a chairman of the National Society of Black Engineers in corporate America. And I've managed $500 million of assets for the support of the helicopter. And I've been able to make things happen. So I encourage you to read more about me. I encourage you to read more about the other candidates to see the differences. And I think what you'll see is that I'm the type of person who is authentic, is here for the right reason, and will get things done as mayor. And I want to also say this one thing. I'm not going to be mayor for more than 8 years if I'm elected, God willing. Because I still want to be an astronaut when I grow up. Thank you so much.
We're going to take a very brief 5-minute recess. 5 minutes, and then we're going to hear from the rest of the candidates.